And when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him, fell down before him, and cried with a loud voice and said, What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High? I adjure thee by God that you do not torment me. For he said unto him, Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. There was an unclean spirit in this man, a demon. And Jesus asked the demon, What is your name? And the demon replied, My name is Legion, for we are many. And I want to tell you the rest of the story of what I want to leave with you tonight. Because the Bible teaches that there is such a thing as a devil, and the Bible teaches that there is such a thing as demons. And these demons have tremendous power and tremendous influence, and they're at work in our world today, and they're at work in Philadelphia today. Here's the disciples in a storm at sea, and there's nothing sadder than a wreck. But the saddest and the most tragic wreck of all is the wreck of a human soul. Christ said, For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? He was comparing the world with the soul. He said, Your soul, your spirit, is more valuable than all the rest of the world put together. How can that be? All the money, all the wealth that there is in this world is not as valuable in the sight of God as your soul. Your soul is that part of you that lives forever. When you were born a living soul, a living spirit, and that part of you is going to live forever. Nothing you can do about it. You were born to live forever. Now your eternal home may be hell or it may be heaven, but you're going to live. And it's up to you to decide which road of life you're going to take. Jesus said there are two roads. There's a broad road that leads to destruction and a narrow road that leads to life eternal. And you have to make a choice. Now in the story that we read about, this boat with Jesus in it and the disciples lands on the beach. And all of a sudden they hear these wild cries on a cliff above them. They see a dreadful wreck and ruin of a man rushing down. He's disheveled, his body is naked, he's gashed, he's bleeding, fragments of chains on his hands and feet. A wild, wretched remnant of a man. Probably came from a fine home. Perhaps a man of superior intelligence in every way. He begins to act strangely, he grows worse. Eventually he leaves home. He was possessed by an unclean spirit. Now the Bible teaches that there are demons that can possess a person. And he was living among the dead. This man was possessed of an unclean spirit, and he lived among other people with unclean spirits. He was spiritually dead. And in destitution and wretchedness, the devil pays his wages. Yes, the devil pays. You serve him. Live separated from God. You may live in a fine home. You may have everything that will bring pleasure and happiness and money, but deep inside, you're not sure that you know Christ. There's something wrong. And eventually, the devil will pay you off because you've neglected Christ and turned your life over to the devil, even though you didn't mean to. You just did it by neglect. You see, you are in torment. Your conscience is in torment. Your conscience acts as a salt in the wound or a whip on your rebellious back. So many in the press tell the story of their torment in drugs. What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? Torment us not. Many people say, What do I have to do with thee? That's what this man said. What do I have to do with you? A working man will say, Well, he's too busy for Christ. A rich man says that religion is for the poor people. An intellectual man says it's for the uneducated. The common man says, I can't understand it. The radical says it isn't revolutionary enough. Whether you like it or not, you will someday have something to do with God at the judgment. Every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess that he's the Christ. Whether you like it or not, someday you will bow.